Hello, good morning students. Welcome back to online classes. So in last class we have discussed on the chapter 2, that is principles of electricity, network theorems and AC principles. In that we have studied about the charges. So there are two types of charges exist in nature. One is of positive charge, another is of negative charge. So this charge is nothing but it is a property of certain particles which is responsible for the electric force. So whatever the electricity is there, that electricity is due to charges, motion of charges. So because of that we consider the concept of charge here in this chapter. So now let us study about the properties of charges, very important part of the charges. So there are two types of charges, positive charges and negative charges. So in that we study the different properties. They are the very important part of properties. So here in properties of charges, what happens? Like charges repel each other. Like charges means similar charges. Similar charges means what? Positive charges. If they brought near to each other, they get repelled. So that is, like charges means same type of charges repel, and unlike charges, they get attract with each other. So unlike charges means the different types of charges. One is of positive charge, another is of negative charge. If they brought near to each other, then the attraction, force of attraction takes place. So that is, unlike charges, they attract each other. So this one is the first property of charge. Next, charges are conserved. Charges are conserved means it is not possible to create the charge or it is not possible to destroy the charge. So because we say that charges are always conserved in nature or in materials, they cannot be created or they cannot be destroyed. So this one is the second property. Third property, charges always reside on the outer surface of a charged conductor. Charge avaglu elli reside aagtavantandre, they are always reside on the outer surface. They always reside on the outer surface of a charged conductor, not in the inside. So they always reside on the outer surface of charged conductor. So this is the third property of charge. Next is, charge is not affected by motion. So charge is not affected means the magnitude of charge or the motion of or content of the charge, it cannot be affected. So charge remains same. So that is, charge is not affected by motion. If you move the charge conductor, it will not affect the charges which are present on its surface. So that is the concept here. New charge move madidrunu enagtadri, whatever the amount of charge is located on the surface, it is not going to be affected if you move the charge conductor. So that is, charge is not affected by motion. Next, charge is quantized. Charge is quantized means we represent the charge in terms of integral values of electron, or it may be integral values of proton. So that is, charge is always represented in integral value. So that is, Q is a charge, it is represented as N into E. So N takes any value, 1 to infinity, plus 1, it takes 1 to infinity value, plus 1, plus 2, like that, up to any values. So that is integral multiple of your charge of electron. So that is nothing but a charge. So therefore, charge is always represented in the form of integral values of charge of electron. So that is, Q is equal to N into E. Next, sixth concept or property is, charge of a single electron, the magnitude of charge of single electron. Magnitude means how much of charge is present in a single electron. One electron aga, how much of charge is present. So that is nothing but a magnitude of charge in a single electron. That is, electron is a negative charge, therefore we represent it e raised to minus. So it has a magnitude of 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. In your book they have mentioned that 1.06218 into 10 raised to minus 19. So this is also right. If you write 1.6, then also it is correct. So that is, the charge of single electron is negative and it is of the magnitude of 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Similarly, the charge of one proton is also same, charge of electron and charge of proton. It is a positive charge, proton is a positive charge, it is represented e raised to plus, and it has the same charge as that of your electron. So that is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Next, moving on to the SI unit of charge. So what is the SI unit of charge? So there, in a SI unit, you are providing the varieties for measurement, physical quantities. There are the SI units are there, like your length, mass. So you are giving the meters, kilometers. So like that, SI unit is provided. Similarly, in our electronics or in our electricity, for charge is also, there is also the one unit is there. So the charge of unit is nothing but the unit of charge is coulomb. So charge is always measured in terms of coulomb. Charge and hang measure martivandre in terms of coulomb. So that is coulomb is coulomb. So this coulomb, it is usually represented as capital C. So the charge of either your electron or our proton, they are represented in the form of capital C. This C is nothing but coulomb. So that is the SI unit of charge of electron. So that is, charge is always represented in a coulomb. So this is named after the French physicist. So who has discovered the concept of force that exists between, electrical force that exists between the charges. So any kind of charges, they may be like charges or they may be unlike charges, between them what happens, a certain kind of electrical force exists. So that concept was given by Charles Augustin de Coulomb. So the French physicist, he has given the concept of electrical force that exists between the two types of charges. They may be like charges or unlike charges, or they may be unlike charges. So between them a kind of electrical force exists. That concept was given by Charles Augustin de Coulomb. One mark sign again kehtara, what is the unit of electric charge? So electric charge, SI unit of electric charge is coulomb. So you have to write proper spellings, that is coulomb. Some students will write as coulomb, so that is wrong. Coulomb is the coulomb. So it was the French physicist name that is given for the SI unit of charge, coulomb. So next, after that, suppose assume that if there are n electrons, they are crossing the conductor, so they are moving inside the conductor, n electrons are there which are moving inside the conductor or moving through the cross section of conductor in time t. So then what happens, the total amount of charge, so that n number of electrons are moving in a conductor, even the conductor and assume madkonri, in this conductor there are totally how many number of electrons, n number of electrons are moving inside this conductor. So cross section of a conductor during the time t, then total charge or net amount of charge is given as multiplication of your n into e. N number of electrons into charge of electron, it gives you the total charge of that system or total charge of that conductor, total charge or net charge. So net charge is equal to n times of e. So this is about the concept of charge. Next, in that charge itself, again we find out how many electrons are present in one coulomb. So we say that 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb of charge, it consists of one electron. So then one coulomb of charge consists of how many electrons? So that is, we calculate number of electrons in one coulomb is equal to 1 electron divided by 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. So it is nearly about 6.25 into 10 raised to 18 electrons are present in one coulomb of charge. So therefore, one coulomb of charge nalli est electrons irthavantandra, it consists of 6.25 into 10 raised to 18. 10 raised to 18 means 10 is multiplied 18 times. and that term is going to be multiplied with 6.25, that many number of electrons are present in a 1 coulomb of charge. So that is calculated with this formula, a very very important concept. From this we come to know about in a 1 coulomb how many number of electrons are present. So next, moving on to the electric current. So very very important term or parameter that is going to be used in our principle of electricity, second concept. Second concept is electric current. Electric current. So in day to day life we come across this electric current, means all of our electrical appliances, they work with the help of electric current. So what is this electrical current actually? So this electric current is nothing but the movement of electrical charges inside the conductor, the movement of electrical charges through a conductor cross section area within given time. In a given time, how many number of charges they are going to move. So that itself, it constitutes the current, movement of electrical charges. Either they may be positive charges or they may be negative charges. Usually we consider the movement of electrons. So they are the part of our electricity. So electric current is nothing but the movement of charges, the movement of charges in flows, that flows through a cross section of conductor in time t. So that is called as electricity. So that electricity is constituted by motion of electrons or motion of your protons. So that is caused by motion of electrons itself is called as electric current. And by definition of electric current, definition. So how we define this electric current? Electric current is defined as, it is defined as the flow of, the rate of flow of electric charges, defined as the rate of flow of, the rate of flow of electric charges, the rate of flow of electric charges through a cross section area, through a cross section area of conductor, through a cross section area of conductor is called as electric current. So that is electric current we define here as the rate of flow of electric charges. Rate of flow of electric charges means what? So in a given time, how much of amount of charges that flow through the conductor? Suppose assume that the time is 1 second. In 1 second, how much of charges flow through the cross section area of conductor? One cross section area at a one time, how much of charges that flow through that conductor itself, we call it as a electrical current. That we call it as a rate of flow of electric charges. The rate of flow of electric charges through a cross section of conductor, cross section area of conductor, is defined as electric current. So therefore, what happens? Let Q be the net amount of electric charge, net total charge. Consider Q be the net total charge flowing through the cross section area of conductor in time t. So that is, in time t, the amount of charge flowing is Q. So then current, electric current is given as current is equal to charge divided by time, charge divided by time. So that is nothing but charge is how much? Q, and time is t. So that is electric current is equal to ratio of Q divided by t. So in short term, we say it as a rate of flow of electric charges. The rate of flow of electric charges through a cross section area of conductor itself, we call it as a current. So then assume that, let us consider that a small charge dq. Let us consider a small charge dq. Yavaglu small amount now hang represent martivu antandre d delta of q, so that is dq. A small charge dq flows through the conductor when during the change in time of dt second. dq charge flows through the conductor when change in time of dt during the across the cross section area of conductor, then the current is given by I is equal to, in small letter current I is given as I is equal to dq divided by dt. So that is, if a small charge of dq that flows through the cross section area of conductor when a change in time of dt takes place, during that time what dq amount of charge flows, that causes the electric current, and that current is represented with a small current I, small letter I. So that is current I, a current is always represented with a capital I or small I. So this is the denomination used for representing your current. So therefore, the small current flowing is represented with a small letter I is equal to dq divided by dt. So this is a concept. And coming to the unit of electric current, so how the unit is there for charge, similarly unit is also there for current. So current is always measured in terms of ampere. Current is measured in terms of ampere. So this ampere is the unit of current, SI unit of current, ampere. Either this current is represented as capital A antare represent martivi, or it may be represented with the three letters as amp. Hang use martivi antandre, in a mathematical notation we represent it as either capital A or ampere. So then what is 1 ampere of current? So when current is said to be 1 ampere, adu kelabodre examination naga, so that is 1 ampere of current. So what is 1 ampere of current? A current is said to be 1 ampere if 1 coulomb of charge flows through the conductor in 1 second. So that is nothing but 1 ampere is equal to ratio of 1 coulomb of charge to that of time second is 1 second. Time of 1 second. So that is, the current is said to be 1 ampere if 1 coulomb of electric charge that flows through a cross section area of conductor in 1 second is called as 1 ampere of current. So this is the SI unit of current. So electric current is over. Next, the direction of current. Next concept is direction of current, a very very important part of our electric current. So what direction we consider for the current movement? Current movement ge yav direction consider martivi, that is also very very important in our electrical circuits. So while calculating the various voltage, current, or designing of any of your electrical circuits, we need the direction of current. So in which direction your current is flowing, so that is also very very important part of the mathematical calculations. So there we need the direction. So that means that in what direction your electrical current is flowing, so that is direction of current. It is also very very important concept. Direction of current or electric current, both are same, direction of current. So now let us consider a conductor. Let us consider the conductor. In this conductor what happens, it is connected to the battery source of EMFE. So it is connected to EMFE of a battery source. So then due to this source what happens, electrons move in this direction. So this is motion of electrons. So that is motion of electrons, motion of electrons. Here it is a battery source which is connected to your conductor. Idhen antiyo kondri conductor, it is a conductor. To this we are connecting a DC source of E voltage is connected, which is having positive terminal. Idu long lead in mattivi positive terminal, short lead represent the negative terminal. Positive and negative are there. Then the electrons flow in this direction. So that is direction motion of electrons from negative terminal of battery through the external conductor, and it passes to the positive terminal of battery. The direction of motion of electrons in the conductor. Conductor nalli electrons heng move aagtav antandre, they move from negative terminal of battery through the positive terminal of battery through external conductor. E external conductor lin heng move aagtadandre, it moves in this direction, negative to positive direction it is moving. So that is the motion of electrons. So we already know that the current is nothing but motion of electrons. Current is constituted by the motion of electrons. Current heng produce agedandre due to the motion of electrons, but actually the direction of current is in opposite to the direction of motion of electrons. So that we call it as a conventional direction of current. Conventional direction of current, the conventional direction of current, conventional direction of current is opposite to the direction of flow of electrons, is opposite to the direction of flow of electrons, direction of flow of or motion of electrons, flow of electrons. So usually current is nothing but it is a motion of electron. Rate of flow of electrons or rate of flow of electric charges is the current. But that current, how we represent, is in the direction opposite to the direction of flow of electrons. Flow of electrons takes place in this direction. Even though we are considering the conventional direction of current, it is moving from positive terminal of battery to the negative terminal of battery through your external conductor. But now in Martivi, current, even if the other linda girtada, current is induced or produced due to the flow of electrons, that direction of current we take it from positive to negative side, positive terminal of battery to the negative terminal of battery in a standard convention. Now standard again tugotivantandra, it is always taken from positive to negative. Throughout the world itself, this notation or direction of current is used for all purposes of our electrical design. Ella electrical design agli, development, circuitry development illi, yavade irli, current is always moving from positive terminal of battery to the negative terminal of battery. But that direction is actually opposite to the direction of flow of electrons, because flow of electrons takes place from a negative terminal of battery to the positive terminal of battery through your external conductor. But by conventional method, the conventional direction of current, or simply we say the direction of current, is always taken from which is opposite to the direction of flow of electrons. So that is nothing but direction of current is, direction of current always is from, current is always from positive terminal of battery, positive terminal of battery to the negative terminal of battery, negative terminal of battery through external conductor, battery through external conductor, through external conductor. It is always opposite to the direction of current. So if they ask in examination direction of current is always from positive terminal of battery to the negative terminal of battery through the external battery, external conductor, or it is opposite to the direction of flow of electrons. So this is the method or direction of current we use in our standard notation in everywhere in a electrical circuits. This convention we use. So that is, current is flowing from positive terminal of battery to the negative terminal of battery. Because of that, this arrow mark we put here in all circuits. So this type of direction, positive to negative direction, that is a conventional direction of current, or direction of current is taken like this. It is from positive to the negative terminal of battery. So next, after this, next term is a potential difference. So next parameter that is going to be used in our electricity is potential difference. What is this potential difference? Next concept is our potential difference. Potential difference denoted as either capital V or small v. So this is the notation used for representing your potential difference. So what is this potential difference? One more term that is going to be used in our electricity. Electricity na again term use aduri already, charge aitu, current aitu. Next is potential difference. What is this potential difference? Potential difference is nothing but the amount of work done in moving unit charge from one point to another point in a closed circuit. One closed circuit is the electrical circuit. In a closed electrical circuit, the amount of work done in moving the unit charge from one point to another point. Then move model, how much of work is done? So that itself we call it as a potential difference. So potential difference is defined as definition of potential difference. It is defined as the amount of work done in moving unit charge from one point to another point, from one point to another point in a closed circuit is called as potential difference. So work aagtadri in moving a unit charge from one point to another point, there is a work is done. So that is nothing but potential difference is equal to ratio of work done divided by charges transferred. How much of charge is transferred? Amount of work done. So per charges, how much of charges are transferred? That itself ratio we call it as a potential difference. So assume that if W be the work done in moving Q amount of charge from one point to another point in a closed circuit. So W be the work done in moving Q amount of charge from one point to another point, one point in the inner point in a closed circuit. So that work done we call it as a potential difference. So that is V is the potential difference. So that is nothing but V is equal to work done divided by charge. So this is the very, very important equation that is used for our potential difference. The ratio of work done divided by charges transferred is called as potential difference. V is the potential difference. So unit of SI unit of potential difference, SI unit of potential difference is volt. Now potential difference anna yad unit nalli measure martivri, it is measured in volt. 5 volt battery, 6 volt battery, 9 volt battery, like that we say the potential difference or electromotive force as in terms of volt and theory. So that is volt. So that is nothing but the potential difference is said to be 1 volt if 1 joule of work is done moving 1 coulomb of electrical charge from one point to the another point in a closed circuit. So that is the potential difference is said to be 1 volt. The potential difference is said to be 1 volt if 1 joule of work is done in moving 1 coulomb of electrical charge. 1 coulomb of electrical charge means how many electrons? 6.25 into 10 raised to 18 electrons. So that is amount of work done in moving 1 coulomb of charge from one point to another point in a closed circuit. So that ratio itself we call it as a 1 volt. So that is potential difference is said to be 1 volt if 1 joule of work is done in moving 1 coulomb of charge from one point to another point in a closed circuit, closed loop electrical circuit is called as 1 volt. So this is the SI unit of volt. So this term also we have studied. Next, moving on to the another two concepts, very, very important concepts. So they are DC source and what is the direct current and alternating current. DC and AC concepts here we study. So that is what is DC and what is AC. And then next is comparison between DC and AC. DC or we call it as a direct current or in short we call it as DC. So direct current, what is this direct current? Direct current, you heard about DC, AC and the words called kelirbodri electrical supply maduvaga. So what is the DC and what is the AC? So whatever the electrical supply you are using in day to day life through the electrical line supply, avu en irthava AC signals irthavri, all are AC. But whereas for operating your electronic devices, nimde electronic device operate agbekandra we need DC. So that is direct current. So what is this direct current? A direct current is nothing but the current which flows in one direction, and its magnitude remains constant with the time. The constant, that is the current which flows in one direction and its magnitude is constant with the time. Such current we call it as a direct current. For example, consider a direct current source like your battery source. So that is positive. Battery source is connected to electrical bulb. So like this glows. Whenever you connect a small electrical bulb here, so then battery source, this one is nothing but battery source or DC source. So DC source, when a DC source is connected across to the bulb, so immediately what happens, bulb glows, where in this one direction flow of current, one way flow, current flows in one direction from positive to negative. Current flows in only one direction from positive to negative. In this direction current flows. E direction a current flow aagtada, immediately this bulb glow as soon as you connect the supply DC source. So this is the concept of direct current, and graphically it is represented. A graph na heng torustivri, it is a time axis. X is considered as a time axis and Y is considered as the magnitude. Then constant voltage or constant current is represented like this. So this is nothing but voltage or current. So this is with the time change adang enagtadri, magnitude remains constant. Andre ik suppose idu 5 ampere athava 5 volt adandra, this 5 volt it remains constant throughout. So that is nothing but the current which flows in one direction, means one direction flow aagtada, and its magnitude andra value of current or voltage, it remains constant. Constant means this remains constant throughout the time idang enagtadri, it remains constant. So this is a direct current. Next is alternating current. So that is called as AC, alternating current AC. The current whose direction and magnitude changes continuously. Continuously and periodically with time, such current we call it as a alternating current. The current whose direction change aagtada as well as magnitude changes continuously and periodically with a period adenagtadri, current changes its direction. Such type of current we call it as a alternating current. In alternating current has half, during half cycle it flows in one direction, and in another half cycle it flows in another direction of current is different, one in a positive direction, another in a negative direction. So the direction of current changes. That means that same, consider the circuit which is connected to the same electrical bulb, to that electrical bulb it is connected, and here supply source it is given like this. A supply source of AC is connected, so this is AC source. So current flows in both the direction, two way flow, because of that bulb glows continuously. So that is the direction of flow of current in this circuit, it is in both the direction. So that is nothing but AC source is connected across the bulb. In this current flows both half cycles. So that means in a graphical represent, how we represent graphically, hang represent Montuori AC. This is a time axis X. So AC means it flows like this. So that is positive, negative. So this is either it is V, instantaneous value, either voltage or current signal. Voltage irabodu, current irabodu. The current whose direction andre idu positive direction ri, idu negative direction, whose direction and magnitude, you magnitude antare, you values ri magnitude, whose direction and magnitude continuously changes, continuous with time, idu note 0.1 second, 0.2. So with, for every time there is a different magnitude value. So that means that the current whose direction and magnitude changes continuously and periodically with time, so that signals we call it as a alternating current or alternating voltage, and is represented like this. Idu one direction, it is for idukella one cycle antivri, here to here we call it as one cycle one cycle, it is half cycle re. This one is half cycle here to here. In half cycle, its direction is in one direction, positive direction, and in other half cycle, it is flowing in another direction. So therefore, current whose direction changes continuously and periodically, such current we call it as a alternating current. So in next class, in study modunu comparison between DC current and alternating current. So thank you.